This is like a 2 to 4 year old, at least he told me it was like probably 5 years old. I'm gonna say it's a little less.
Yeah.
I haven't really explored the situation, but I'll let you choose.
Well, this one's a lot more developed in the roots, huh?
Yeah. It is a... I'd say so. For me, they're both interesting.
So, would you cut these off?
Right now, no. But we'll get into that. Let's decide first which one you like better. Because, yeah, when choosing a tree, basically you want to look at all the surface roots. You want to have like a radial root system, because when you expose the roots, it's going to look better and aged.
Yeah, this guy definitely has better roots.
It definitely has a lot more roots, feeder roots.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of surface roots, there's a big one here, a big one here, a big one here. Basically, you have three roots. It's lacking a lot of root here. If you want to expose it, look nice.
Uh-huh.
This side is kind of weakish. Also, in terms of root, so they're both similar. One strong, two, three. Ideally, you'd have like 8, 10, whatever. As many as you can, but the fact that it has more, it doesn't mean that it's weak or anything. It just, this one is more developed. It's a little more thick.
It does. It looks older, doesn't it?
Branch. It looks older. So I give it to you. Which one you want? It doesn't really matter. In terms of branching. That one looks like it has more branches coming out. It's kind of the same, just this one lacks from here to here, but
yeah.
They will grow. You know, these are all possible
areas. Yeah.
Areas where the buds will come out and branch. The thing we want to avoid is having parallel or horizontal branches more than two. Or more than one, meaning this is the main trunk, and then I have 1, 2, 3, 4 in the same area. And the reason is very, very important is that if you let it all grow, this area will swallow, and instead of having a tapered trunk,
okay,
you're gonna have an inverse taper where the trunk thickens up and then goes back, which is ugly and really,
yeah,
not something you want.
So with that guy, would you knock down,
yeah, means that
everything?
We will leave just one.
So I like the look of this tree better.
Yeah.
But this tree looks like, for someone that's beginning, it's much hardier than this one looks like.
I think they have enough feeder roots, to be honest, and they will hold perfectly fine.
Okay.
Supposedly. I think that tree is more interesting because it has more branch options.
Absolutely,
already.
Absolutely, yeah.
And here we're going to have to knock down three of them.
It's going to need
And then we're going to have to knock down two of these.
Oh, really?
Sorry, one. Just keep two. So that means that in the end,
so you think you would pull this one off?
If I had to choose,
that would be the.
I would probably choose that one, but I'd be also interested in having a thicker trunk. But they're the same, right? So they're kind of the same. It's kind of like this one will probably develop faster just because he has already a root system that is bigger. That one, we have to see how he reacts, but. Deciduous trees, in this case, these Japanese maples, they are very hardy. In terms of root pruning, you can almost...
Pretty resilient.
Yeah, you can almost take down a bunch of roots and they'll still hold together.
Decisions,
yeah.
I guess I've been holding this one the whole time. I'll do this guy.
All right. I actually would choose that as well, so I'm happy you choose that.
Yeah. On this guy, though, I feel like if you cut this one off...
Yeah.
When cut these two, I don't think that's the best choice, mm-hmm. but I feel like that would be the coolest. Mm. The coolest look to it.
So, this is where we think about what kind of style we want to give it, right? It's probably, he has already some turns and all that. If we knock this one down, the tree will be leaning towards one side. Uh-huh. As you plant it like this, it's still like a little too much going there. I would personally take this one down, so keep this one. Also, you don't want to have a branch and
so close.
And a main trunk of the same thickness. The trunk needs to be thick, and then the branches need to taper out.
Get the variation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
Decided?
Awesome.
All right. So next step is what we want with the tree. We want it to develop the thick nut, and that comes with the pot choice. If you go for a small pot, the tree will be restrained, and the more roots you have, the more the upper part also will develop. And the more finer roots, feeder roots, it develops, the more short the internodes. The internodes is the space between the buds. In the next one, so this is an internode, and then you got a shorter, and shorter.
So these ones seem pretty close together.
This one's pretty nice.
So
this one doesn't have so much shorter internodes. So
will there more that'll grow along there?
Yeah, it's natural that, and you can see here, there's a bud here. So each section is basically...
It will start to...
It can develop, it depends on the tree and what you do, how you cut it back and all that.
So are you thinking short and fat?
I think that a nice pot with a nice size, let it develop, let it grow, let it... especially the trunk, let it grow as much as you can so that you can later on either cut back or just maintain a thick trunk and develop the branches.
So we cut this. Is this one small enough to the main trunk? You're thinking cut this guy.
Right now I don't want to cut back much. I wouldn't cut back much.
Because there is quite a bit of plant coming off here.
I would just basically cut the ones that we know that we're not going to use or that will cause inverse taper or swelling, and then just let them go out, because later on when the tree is at the thickness that we desire, that's when we're going to go back, and we can always cut back. You can always, let's say you keep this one and it grows, it develops, it gets so thick that the trunk is also thick, you can always cut back. You should come here and you can also have something like this where you get it all completely at that time. But the important thing is that right now it grows, and then when it's at desired stage, then we'll get back again.
Do people keep 1, 2, 3, or is that too much coming out of...
It's too much. Normally you want to keep just one branch at one horizontal.
Yeah, boom, boom.
Yeah.
Cool.
So So we're gonna do some cutting in a couple of them. But before we do the repotting and cut it back, well, no, it's night. Maybe the roots are not gonna dry, and that would be a problem if it was sunny and you wanted to repot immediately. Right now we have time to prepare the pots, decide about the pots, and then go back and okay, this is the style I want. I'm gonna cut this one. This one is in this one. So let's go with the pots. I have it's pre-bonsai at this stage, so we're not gonna put it in a shallow, pretty fancy pot.
Okay.
We wanted to think. Okay, what do we want? We want the roots to grow. We wanted how much do we want it to grow, and if I really didn't want to touch the tree at all for a long time, I probably didn't think about one of the big ones. This is too small. This in a couple of years, it's all full of roots and you're gonna be repotting and all that. Even in a year.
How long are we gonna keep it in here before we...
I'd say I like to repot my trees, young trees, every 2 to 3 years. But in this stage, I really want them to just expand.
Well, awesome.
So I think this is going to be too small. I also think that this hole is too small. It needs drainage. The water needs to come out, because if you let water sit a long time, or if it gets too moist, you might end up with a lot of roots. I think that this is interesting because it has a lot of area for the roots to expand. Has a good height, it's not deep, but on a deciduous tree, you want the roots to go lateral.
Yeah.
So this is enough pot to sustain the tree, for example, for 3 years.
Cool.
And let it just
eat. Yeah, it's a cool looking pot too.
And it's a good looking pot. So I'd say that.
Awesome.
That's the one to go there. I don't want to go too for a huge one on this one, but I'll definitely go with something big as well.
So the big roots we have here, mm-hmm. Are there any more that are going to develop?
Yeah.
Or these?
Well, you can develop more roots. That's, you know.
Are there any tricks to do that?
Do you
go in there and can you do something to essentially start or expand a root?
No, just keep it in the soil. If it was a developed tree, it would be putting the tree showing these superficial roots.
Uh-huh.
And that would not develop any roots over here. But in this case, we wouldn't give it as much chance as we want right now. So we're going to cover it probably until here, to keep a layer of soil, to keep this moist enough in the summer. And it's natural that it will grow roots all over. And this one is actually very interesting because it has a little bit of flair. I like this one. This one is gonna have very thick root here that might just get too chunky with time.
So I kind of like the big, not necessarily a root ball, but you get those thick, kind of veiny looking.
Yeah, exactly. So that's what you can do here. Once we cover it, let it grow, and in 3 years, there will be plenty of roots, and that's when you start
developing.
If that time the thickness is already good enough, which might not be, I'd say 3 to 5 years, that's when you start exposing a little bit of the roots and you'll start seeing them on the surface of the soil.
Cool.
But in the prime, you know, in the first stages.
These guys are hanging out while we get them ready.
So you need for that pot 1, 2, 3, 4 of these guys. How to do it. In a second, I'm gonna need something like that. It's a small one. Not this. Let's see. It's better. Yeah, I think it's good. Alright. If you want to do it. Mm-hmm. basically, you give it a fold. This is the other thing, you give it a fold. And you want this distance to be the same as here or the same as here. In this case, if you put it the same as here, it's better because it's going to be stuck.
Okay.
Then, follow like this. It's nicer because it holds it better.
Yeah, I like that.
I need 1, 2. Three more. Only one. Let's see.
So there's a reason why you do it in this shape or style?
You know.
You just, this is how you people, like to
that's
do?
How people do it. That's there's a couple things that people do different. I like this just because it's easier for me. It doesn't even mean that it's right or wrong.
Yeah.
I just got used to this.
You definitely fold it over a little better than I do.
Well,
it's a little prettier.
I'm not always a perfectionist. I'm gonna go to the next step and I'll let you know. You got your wire cutter as well. Can you use it? So the next step.
This one.
Yeah, wire cutter. Nice. One of the most important things when it's a new tree and a young tree planting is that when you put in the soil, you make sure that the tree is secure where it doesn't move at all. Because when young trees are developing roots, or any tree developing roots, if it starts moving when you water, when there's wind or whatever, those young roots trying to grow, those little cells will break and the roots will just not grow.
Okay.
So we wanna kind of attach with a wire. In this case, we're gonna put like two wires coming out here, two here, and then they will cross so that it secures the tree.
So we just do a new shape up?
Yeah, just like this.
Awesome. So how far up from the bottom should
just
they
enough
be?
So that you have enough to go around the tree. So I'm gonna say probably only cut it over here.
Maybe like 8 inches up, 10 inches up.
Yeah. Something like that. And then you can just put it like this, but I prefer to do something else.
Bubbles.
So, because you're gonna, on the other side, you're gonna put it crossing this way, you want to put it on this edge so that it doesn't move the thing when you're tying it up. And I personally like to fold it with this wire thing, this wire.
Good corner.
Because if you don't do this nicely, it will just slide. Oh, what's that?
Child abduction.
Oh God.
Don't abduct children.
Yeah. And we'll just put it like this for now. So we can
just fold it down.
Yeah.
And
that
one
as well. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Got my fingers. So, and then are we doing, it's all do here to here, and then you're we doing here to here?
So this one's done, and you're going to do one here to here.
And okay, so that's it?
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. Correct it if, let me see your pliers, if it's still loose, you just come here and then you just give it like that.
Cool.
This is normally done after we stretch them out, and just do it like this. So they're coming a little apart, so what we do is just press here all these guys. So, put it in place.
One of us is better than the other.
Oh, I've been doing it.
Yeah, I know. It shows. It definitely shows.
Yeah.
That's
good.
All right.
Perfect. Put it here. Put it here. Bam. Bam. And now we're going to start with the saw. This is a Bonsai special soil. This soil just allows moisture airflow. Holding water. I tweaked it so that there's some dust that ends up piling up in the pot, and if you don't sift it, it goes to the bottom.
Start clogging up.
Yeah, exactly. So you want to have the drain.
The cleaner, the better.
Yeah.
Seems like with all this, the finer, the better it is.
The
movements and the soil.
Let's see what I get. We're gonna do a cone right now, but
all right.
I'll show you why.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, I'm not happy with you guys. In this case, normally in these kind of trees, deciduous trees, if there was like thick roots here coming out, and you put it here, we'll just leave the tree. I'll just cut it and keep the radial ones. This tree is perfectly fine already. But we want to try to keep them radial, spread in the pot. And this is perfect. Let me see my. And try to take a little bit of the soil. We can just clean it up, flush it with water in these trees. This was a juniper. A pine, you don't want to touch too much. These ones you can cut a lot. Juniper spines, you don't want to cut more than 30%
of the time.
And the pines and the junipers, the strength comes from the roots. So below the trunk, it's very important that you keep a good amount of roots. And these ones, no. These ones you can go flat.
Since they both these are.
Yeah, that one is perfect. I think that
good choice.
The guy that sold this kind of prepared it.
Yeah,
it's not always the case. Yeah, this is pretty good. I'm just gonna try to make it right. You know what? I'm gonna put it in water and try it. This is the soil.
So for years, you're trying to break the roots up a little bit?
Yeah.
Mine's so small anyways, there's not a whole lot to do.
So you can do it. Let me see yours. Just put it here.
And you just, we're just trying to open up the root ball?
Yeah. Try to move the soil, the whole soil. If it was like clay soil, you don't want to have clay soil in your tree. You don't want to have anything that is too compact. It doesn't allow the roots to develop properly. That's why this soil is so
soft,
coarse.
So it looks like it's kind of got a rocky soil in there too, huh?
Yeah, that's nothing important. If it was like mud, it's this is a nice root system.
I like it. Looking tree.
Yeah. The material this guy has is awesome. I bought Japanese maples before. They didn't have these short internodes.
So do you keep this guy like a honey hole secret? You don't tell anybody about it? When you go fish and you lie, you tell me you went the other way?
It's almost like that. Like for example, I don't feel like he had a lot of material this year. So I was kind of eager to get a lot. And I know that next year he's opening a nursery, so it's going to be harder.
More people interested also, as well, yeah, huh?
Also more expensive because he's licensing and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But he's just someone that I met on the Facebook groups. Yeah, you see this root? Super thick, coming a little above the soil. I don't fancy that much, but I also don't fancy this one.
So
I could just
cut
it.
Those both look like good big main roots, yeah. Huh?
Yeah, but you see here?
It's too, it's not pretty enough.
No, it's coming a little to the top. So if I want to cut a big root, I can just cut it all. In this case, it doesn't have anything attached, doesn't have fine roots, so it's probably not great. But if you see here, there's a little thin root coming out of here. So if I cut right after, where the root is, this will survive.
Continue moving. Yeah.
And we'll taper it. This one, I really dislike it. There's nothing here extremely interesting.
Get rid of that dude, huh? Yeah, if this was a walnut tree, you want that big burr along there for that beautiful taste.
I got rid of this one, and then I got another one here. So my decision is that, and I'm not going to have roots here to make it radial and pretty, so I'm going to chop it off. I'm going to go and take it out.
And you got to leave that last one. Oh, baby.
Yeah.
It's a big tree.
So it wasn't that much of a thing. And then we have roots coming up here that are, if I want to keep it tapered here, this is like coming up. So,
and it's it's going down, came back up.
Yeah. I'm a little torn to do. I didn't want to cut tremendously, but there's something here that I think it's loose already.
Pulling on it like that, huh? Just yank it out, it's fine.
So there's a root coming here. So if I want to keep this all alive, I want to keep some kind of root that sustains it. I'm gonna cut for now here. Yeah.
I feel you're picking out quite a bit.
This one is coming straight up. I don't want that.
So, once we put this in here, we want to never see the roots again?
Yes, into this situation.
We don't want that spider web, a cool roots.
No.
Where the gnome people live underneath.
You want them to develop more, find the roots here, you know, and it might happen. So you want to give it a chance to make it even a better.
Gotcha.
We call it nabari. Nabari is basically Japanese word for superficial roots, exposed roots. And this is fine, I think, for me. Let me see. Yours is great. They're all coming from the same, even though this one's go very low. It's the amount of roots that I don't want to.
Yeah, it looks like it's fine already.
Take less.
Yeah.
Than it is. I do want a chance to.
Everything looks like it's coming down.
Yeah.
So untangle the roots.
Untangle a little, and then when we press it down, we'll press it down so that this tries to lift a little. We'll see. This is good though. It's great. So, if I had to choose the front, because there's always the front and the back, right? And we choose base first on the root system, then on the movement of the trunk.
Yeah, well, it looks like you got a great front right there, huh? Yeah,
so I try to avoid have a root on the side, just parallel.
Uh-huh.
Like it be a little on the side just to give it more perspective of movement. So I would probably go with this as a front.
So it's the front of the pot?
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks good.
It's good. You do have a branch just coming straight at you, which you don't want in the front. You can have it, like the first branch normally is 2/3 of the height of the tree, and you got to picture in the future as well.
So should we trim everything under that big guy?
Yes and no. Japanese maples are also looking good a lot of times with branches coming down here. So this is just a general rule, but I don't guide myself too much. The only thing you don't want is having something straight at you.
Why?
Which is this one. Because when you look at the tree, it's just like
just not taking, kosher.
It's covering all the movement.
Yeah.
So you kind of want to have a clean front up to 2/3.
Okay.
And then 2/3 of a thing.
Sniff that dude?
I don't know. Let's think. Maybe.
Should we plant him first?
Yes. We can all also
see,
do that.
See, that looks kind of cool right there.
Exactly.
We split him.
But like this. So he was like this and he comes straight at you. But if you put it like this,
we still got good looking roots.
Now you don't have to cut it.
Yeah.
Right?
So
that's a very good option.
Are you thinking?
I'm thinking
we
like
leave
this.
That guy in the back for some foliage?
Not yet. I think that
you're too excited.
I think for me
cut nothing.
The thicker one would go. Because if you leave both thick ones, they will thicken the same. And if you leave a weaker one, this will be more like a branch, and like this, like two trunks. But you can also leave this one, and you can also eliminate this one, and make it like a.
But you don't.
A trunk that splits in two.
I mean, the trifecta right here. You know what I'm thinking?
The what?
The trifecta. 1, 2, 3.
No.
Don't save them all, huh?
No. It's hard.
I mean, and this one's got character on it too.
Yeah.
You know, and this one splits again.
The cool thing about it here is that you can choose either.
We just leave this one hungrier.
Yeah, you can even take this one out later on, or even today, cut this one so that it thickens and then it has a little taper and it gives more.
It goes a different thing. Way. Yeah.
Or you can just leave it as thick as it is, and in the future, this will be like a trunk that is two like this, and then you'll have branches.
I do like
here,
the two trunker,
but then this one will stop around here somewhere, where these ones will go there,
where this one can come down.
Yeah, but you want to come down probably before this, so you'd have to cut it still here so that this one then will do that movement. If you want,
we'll see what the tree wants, huh?
But yeah, so I'd say avoid having a straight pointing at you, and this will probably be a good
cool.
front.
Cool, cool.
Now I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna attach mine. Yeah. We have dirt enough there. And I gotta make a decision as well. So I'm gonna make my decision in a snap though. Roots, that one is too high though. That one is also too high.
I'm gonna take that last one out.
Ciao. And then I'm gonna have another trunk split just like that, that I'll wire later on. We're not gonna wire it today because it doesn't make sense. Because the tree is gonna be tall.
Still
if
young.
You put wire, it's gonna mark the
mark the bark. Trunk.
Yeah. But I don't want all these coming from the same place, so I'll leave that one. And just make sure that I'm making the right choice here.
So I heard the other day they said that when you cut a plant, they scream. It's just at such a high frequency that we don't hear it.
Really?
Yeah. So, as a vegetarian, you guys are just a monster.
Sorry, I'm a monster because
absolutely.
I don't even.
I can almost hear it now.
So I have one coming here, which was gonna open that, and then I have this competing with that. It's three branches, which I don't like. It's gonna create swelling.
Almost looks like, well, which one would you say is the main one? It almost looks like a pretty even split.
I want to keep this one just because this is going to be like, I was debating if I should just do this, but it's still three coming out of the same place.
Go even lower, huh?
I don't want to create that inverse taper thing. And I always leave like a half an inch because this will die back. If you cut it too short, it might actually die back the whole trunk. So it's important that you leave this to dry, and then next spring or fall, when it's already dry, you're going to go to the. There's also another small one here, I'm going to take it out. There's two here competing. This is going to this side, this is going to this side. So that it is on the side. already on the side, so I'm gonna this is not coming from the same place, it's already on top of the tree, so
so you think a lot of my branches should go?
That's up to you. Here's what I would do.
So we're thinking, get rid of this guy.
So, then we should front. If it was me,
so maybe leave this guy, trim it, trim the back up, and then, I don't know if we should.
I would clean everything here in the same line, but this one, you like this one, right?
I do.
The only thing about this one is that, in terms of movement, ideally, it would be kind of more like this.
Yeah.
But you can always just chop this. Leave this one, and you're already correct. But you can also leave it like this, perfectly fine. I would limit this growth here by cutting it a little, whatever, so that this one grows and this one doesn't grow as the same thing.
Yeah, okay.
Good luck.
So, which guy are you using?
So you want to use this one because of the thickness. If it was like this, go for the thinner.
Okay, so we're thinking.
So if you're keeping this one, I would start by cleaning up.
Okay, I'll start the back and then get going.
Just clean a little stuff. And then these ones are so thin that you can clean flush to the trunk.
Okay, so you want me to cut this guy?
No, just the small ones.
Gotcha.
From the same horizontal, yeah.
Screaming already. Okay, so this guy, should we pull these guys?
No. Leave those ones are good. There's nothing else in the same line.
Okay, so
you're only focusing on this same parallel area. Yeah.
For this guy too?
No. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm pulling. I'm taking
that one. You can use this. It's a lot easier. It's so thin.
Okay.
That one is good for thicker. Yeah.
So
probably want to do the rest.
Pull them all off?
Yeah. Anything that is coming from the same kind of thing. Man, you killed it. Sorry, James.
Okay. So that
still,
looks.
So you still have this one?
Okay.
And
should pull this guy off?
Not necessarily. Now? Yeah, because it's already. So
there's
it's
an
not
itty bitty. Okay.
Yeah.
I like.
Yeah. These ones are very close to each other, but for now, I wouldn't do anything.
Got it.
I would limit the growth of this one.
Okay,
by
so
it somewhere where you feel comfortable. So if you look at it,
so maybe right here.
Yeah, it's gonna
here
go
even lower.
So you see where these branches are coming.
Yeah,
these ones will fill up the canopy here. So you want to fill up the canopy lower than that.
Okay,
and so that they don't interfere around there.
Still too high.
Let's see. Take it out. I can do my stages.
It's like, yeah, you're saying there's too many up top.
And the thing is that when you leave the tip of the branch, you will keep growing or thicken up this, and then suddenly you don't have any distinction between trunks and branches. That's cool.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's cool. So, going up the line, over here, there's like three in the same place.
Okay, so now we just want to kind of clean up. So it's kind of nice going off this way,
exactly.
Huh?
So this something. One, for example, is going to interfere here. So you might want to take that one.
And then we'll leave this guy coming out the back.
Yeah. The back ones are very important to give some perspective. Yeah.
And then up here.
Probably, no, let's say probably this one for now, because you got two in the same.
So what about up here, though?
Hold it there. Let me see.
So
there you're going to make a decision which one you wanted as an apex. Which one looks like a more natural line?
I mean, neither one of them. They both are.
They kind of like.
So fall. Where's the front? If this is the front of our tree here,
yeah.
It almost
goes like this.
Okay, that's the one.
Yeah.
So we're taking this one guy off. You think that's a good? Both look great up there.
So you're gonna develop something here. So it's gonna have a lot of development here. So you kind of want to balance. You're gonna have to make a decision. Do I want to keep this weird one and then straighten out with wire? Do I want to just keep this one? Yeah, you can leave two here, right? So you can.
So can we leave both of these, or you want to take one?
You can leave both of those, but. As an apex, you want to have one that is better than the other one.
Then pull this guy, so we're this way and that way. Or then keep this in, move it around, and then we can fill this other stuff in.
This is easily bent with wire later. So I would probably fall into this one. And then...
Which one?
Get rid of this here. If I keep this one.
So you think keep both the big ones and clean it up?
Keep this one. Get rid of this one. Take this down, take this down, take this down, and just keep this one. That's what I would do.
Oh.
You don't have to. You can leave them both.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. And you've done this a little bit more than I have.
Where does
this guy get cut? Should we leave him up a little bit?
Yeah.
No, take him all the way down, huh?
Oh, that's the wire one. You want to have clean cuts, so you use the.
Gotcha. So with this guy,
you want to take it down?
Cut him up a node.
Yeah.
Like right there.
Yeah.
Oh man, still a good looking tree. You know?
And you can easily.
So and then
let's say you're undecided right now.
Should we cut this guy and leave this one?
Well, you're gonna have a trunk, right?
This guy off.
So you can only have one branch coming out.
So
basically,
both.
You have to make a decision between these three. Now these ones are all vertical, so they don't make sense because the branch goes to the side. So I'd say you just
take them off.
Yeah.
Now you can hear him, right? Okay.
Now, let's say.
You think we should do.
Does this look weird to you right now? Because it's so not with the flow.
Which one? What are you talking
this
about?
This one? When it turns. It does look a little weird, right?
So, what do you think? You want to tie him up now?
Get
the wire that is proportional. So we're thinking, we just kind of want to pull this guy over, huh?
We just want to straighten it a little without breaking. And then we're going to be careful because in about 3 months, we're going to take the wire out so that it don't scar it. And we also want to be careful with the buds in the branches, not breaking them, not smooshing them, so that we can have them grow. So I'm gonna try to be very careful. I'm gonna do it just because I've done it a little more.
trying to avoid branches and buds. There's a couple buds there. And over here, I want to tie a little more. And there's a lot of buds here. I just finished there, and that's it. Then we cut off the wire that is not needed in the bottom and on top.
So are we gonna?
Yep. Okay, so.
Cool. So we're just gonna snap that there.
Stick it there.
There.
Yeah. And now, gently. These guys can break.
It's kind of more like them.
If I break it.
Yeah, I'll break them myself.
I'll have to pay you cheap. And now it does look more natural. Right? And over time, as it thickens, you won't even notice.
Cool.
Right, it's not weird. It's not weird anymore. All right, next step. Basically, so you see these roots, in this case, they're falling off the pot. If I plant it like this, these roots will start circling around the pot, make like a spaghetti thing that you want to avoid, because it's never going to work. So I'm going to him in this case so that it doesn't happen. Anything that is too long. This one is also going sideways. In your case you have plenty of space, which is cool. And my friend, it doesn't matter because the body's long, but see, this is my front. I cross the wire here.
Oh, is he pretty much holding them in place?
Yeah, without crushing roots, but holding them. And I just first get them like that. I can even use the wire here. You see these roots coming up? This wire is gonna come to the top of it, so it's gonna hold them down, which is cool. In your case, you gotta be more careful just to make sure that you get the front right.
Are we trying to
right.
bury the roots under the
after. So okay, we're gonna so put we're more soil on top. Yeah, out. Right now we just fill up 50% of the pot because it's gonna take more soil on top. Yeah. And as you put soil, you can hold the root down and then pour soil on top and
then it goes where
so
we
right
want.
Now we just want to kind of...
So then with this guy...
So... Cross it. Behind. Oh.
There goes all that work, huh?
Yeah. It doesn't matter because we're going to just, but you're going to cross it so that.
Cross them in the back and then bring them back around.
Exactly. Now we're going to tighten them at the end. And this one's going to go to the front. These roots there. Now you can just cut the wire, the excess wire.
So just, it all we're leaving easier. Them super loose then.
Yeah. For now, we're gonna tighten it up right now. I just wanna get it in place. Now with the pliers. I'm gonna hold the tree, make sure that the roots are in place. Sometimes you need to, in this case, let me just see, try to
separate.
Let's see if they are like this switch here.
Is it bring it out. It?
Yeah.
And then we want to bring him all the way to the end on that guy?
For now, like this. Now we're gonna focus just on the wire, all the tree. And what I do is this. I don't want to smoosh them, but I want it to be secure. So I pull and I twist. And probably gonna have to cut the wires again. It's all good, it's all good. Hold it if you want. You can hold if you put your, yeah. Pull it a little up. Yeah. And stop right there so that we don't get a big mark on the trunk.
You tie this guy up a little bit. Up
more. I'm gonna cut first and then I can do the final tightening.
So, do we want him going straight up 100%?
Mm-hmm.
We like him like leaned over a little bit.
In this case, I like these, the maples, unless there's some kind of feature in the maple that looks good.
So you think this is up enough? Because he's a little bit leaning.
I would straighten it up. Okay. Yeah, but you can also correct that
later on.
Later on.
Repot.
But right now.
Cool.
So then cut this more close and you're going to still tighten a little more.
A little more?
Well, not too much just because you can leave a scar. But also in like 3 months or so, we can always take that wire out because the roots might already be stable. I'm gonna do a, you see here, this lifting up.
Yes, yeah, so you don't like
I'm gonna
there.
Actually use this.
I'm gonna smash it down.
Yeah.
Cool.
Where I want it, pull, and twist. Okay, it's getting into the trunk, not into the very thin roots.
So
you have to stretch the wire.
Okay, so we want it decently tight.
Yeah,
just
I mean,
not gouging.
Yeah. It doesn't have to be much because now that we're going to put the soil,
hold us.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
But we just want it firmly in place.
So these guys are going to come here. Okay.
So yeah, one of the things that is happening here is that they are all lifting up.
We're kind of,
so
yeah.
We
put them in place.
Try to get them to go lower. And once we put soil now on top of it, they will. Okay, this is very long. Can always try to bury it. And this one you're gonna have to hold it most likely, or maybe like this we get there. Yeah, now that you put the soil, they will all.
Cool. Right, should we leave this and let the new soil hold us down since you got the big roots in?
Yeah. Now we're gonna put soil. So basically, I just put it on the top. And we will now go down. We're gonna do something else that will help the roots go down a little. The soil should not be like at the rim, because when you water, the water is just going to go to the sides, and this cold water will still go to the bottom. There's one final, there's no, there's a couple final steps. Let me just get so busy, because
it is insane how almost completely different they look, you know?
Right.
They still have like their original character, but I mean, trimming them up really does change them quite a bit.
Yeah. You make great decisions.
It's much cleaner. It's a much cleaner tree.
But you see how much more branches that one has.
Yeah.
That one was the right choice.
Yeah.
If I had to choose, I would choose that one definitely. Although he has less roots.
But that was the, and as a beginner, this one definitely looks hardier.
Yeah.
You know? But this one definitely looks like it could be a super cool.
It's just that it has so many branches already that once the leaves come out, you already feel
really
like,
gonna
oh,
get that
it already one, looks like a tree.
That's what I need.
Right? So the final step basically is getting chopstick, and it's not perfectionist stuff, but I don't know where it is when it comes off to.
So I saw you moving around roots in one of your videos.
Moving around?
I think you were placing them under the
like
wires.
This? Yeah. Well, that one, there were so many trees that I had to place them under like a cage of wires.
Yeah, everything bent over. And pushed around.
So one side of the chopstick has an angle, and we make it pointy so that it penetrates the soil. And the logic behind having this angle is that when you're putting the chopstick, this angle is enough to open the soil, push the roots downwards, and get the soil into the holes. This case we don't have a lot of roots, so we don't really have to worry that much.
Yeah, with this guy.
But what do you want to do basically is like on an angle 45 degrees or so, holding the soil so that it doesn't, if you do just like this, everything is moving around. If you hold it and you just do it between your fingers and you want it, kind of like press, but without crushing, and then go up and down until it fills the crack. Without crushing, I'm just like, if there was a lot of roots, this would be extremely important. I'm just trying to push where the roots are more.
Give us a little, I'm just doing this for fun then.
Yeah. Where there's more of a root ball in the middle where there might be spaces, that's where you want to fill up. So give it an angle always to the center of the tree. Don't be too hard so that you don't break the roots. It's really only needed around the root system.
So doing that sure is not going to help me out.
And you want to keep looking if the tree shifts.
So, okay.
Like if it's not straight anymore. Because in that case, you want to hold the tree. And for example, let's say if I now want it to move a little there, I'm lifting up a little. I'm pushing it again. So
more. Gotcha. For me, that was gorgeous.
Now these chopsticks are.
Do we want a mound on them?
A what?
A mound, or do we want them all flat at the top?
Oh, here.
Yeah.
The surface. Flattish, a little slope, but nothing much. But we're gonna do something still.
A little more.
So I'm gonna use this one that is a little thinner, penetrates better, just to see if there's any hole left. And then I'm gonna use this one. But yeah. One last step
And I do have to chopstick these. Got my hands on the side. And just hit it a couple of times. This will help filling up any thing that is under.
So that's why we use angled rocks and not smooth ones.
There you go.
Very good.
That's good. It's good.
Amazing.
Yeah. It's good.
You think there's more now?
No, it's good. Now, I want to water from above, plenty, so that it drains all the dust first, and the dust doesn't get like.
Do we want to get our trees wet?
Yeah. All wet. Now, you want it just draining that dust. I put it on the floor. Surface.
It's a good one.
We know that we have hot summers, and when it goes above 75 Fahrenheit, the soil dries very fast. And if it dries too much on the surface, you end up losing roots if they're not well established.
We're mulching.
So we use sphagnum moss. They'll keep the moist on top of the hole for a longer. Around the roots. Make sure I leave the situation. This promotes root growth, so around that tree, around the trunk.
So do you want to keep this wet, or is it just normal watering and it holds extra water?
So you want to keep it only moist. When you water, it's going to be wet.
So how often are you watering?
That comes down to monitoring the soil. I'm going to show you a little trick also. Good thing I'm glad you asked that, because it's pretty important in most problems with beginners is watering, not knowing when, if it's good enough or not. Let me just go here first. Easier to work the sphagnum moss if it's a little moist. What I'm going to do is just take a little around here, and this will keep the
moist right there.
You also will you'll see the color change. But this is not going to look like this, because we're going to do something else.
Oh, you can put a little rock on top, huh?
Nah.
A little cherry on the sundae.
I see people like, oh, you took it.
Yeah. You should throw all this on top.
Just to give it weight so that it doesn't fly out. And you probably could, now you want to spread it like in a thin layer.
Cool.
This is sphagnum moss as well, but it was dyed just because it allows me to see the color change from black to grayish when it's dry. And over on yours.
It almost looks like crushed up bones of your enemies.
You know? Yeah. just put a little leaf there.
We're just looking for just an itty bitty sprinkle.
Yep.
and this has a seeds of a special moss mixed with a sphagnum.
So does that grow?
So it grows a very thin
little layer
Japanese moss.
Perfecto. Bit.
So you now take a little bit of this and you sprinkle on top of it. It will help developing that green
special
moss.
Japanese moss seeds, huh?
Yeah, sounds really good again.
Yeah. A little more?
Huh?
We'll look here around the ears. Yeah, exactly. That's worth some money.
Right? Now, for me, it's a lot easier to just come here and do this thing. Oh, shit. And this will push kind of the moss.
God,
first.
Yeah. You get her wet.
This is wet, which is not good.
Yeah.
To dry it, but. And final touch. I just do this. Get my tool here. And just try to connect the moss with the dirt, with the soil.
A little tampering.
Yeah. So especially around the trunk, we want to
nice
get those
tight
roots and not smooshing, but just keeping connected.
Is it a fancy ass tamper or what?
Yeah.
So are these strictly water all the time, or you got some secret juice you throw on there?
The watering situation. I still use this. It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or not. We don't want to be close to the roots because we don't want to disturb the roots at all right now. But yeah, let's see, this is the...
Luckily I have a small root ball.
Alright, so something happened here, which was the front. Our front ideally was this. And it doesn't matter, I did this with a very mature special tree.
So I don't like having this be the front either. I like everything on the diagonal.
That's
you know?
Why you did it.
Perspective.
Yeah. So this for me would be the ideal front.
It is, yes.
Whenever we repot, it's always correctable. Just keep in mind that when you're trimming in the future,
this does look a little
you want to think about it this way.
Basic, huh? This definitely does give it more of a
it happens all the
curve.
Time.
Curve.
Normally the apex also leans a little to you on the front, so that's why I'm just giving it a little touch. You don't want it to go to the back.
Okay.
It just a slight touch.
Yeah, well, if we bring this way and that way.
Yeah. And it's
magical.
Kinda... Now this, I just put it away from the roots, and I'm gonna put it all the way down. This is a water moist control. When you see the top layer dry, you're gonna think, okay, I have to water. You might be in doubt, like, I don't know if I'm gonna water, and if it rains tomorrow, I'm not gonna water. But it's important to come here.
Today. I thought it was supposed to rain
Monday. 2 days.
Okay, I want
it. Friday. Not sure. So this.
And then we can see.
You'll see. You'll touch it.
It's
and
wet.
You'll see it's wet. No need. Or you can, instead of doing like a full water, you just wanna.
A little smidge it.
Exactly. It's just important that you take it and you put it on the same place so that you don't disturb.
Gotcha. Yeah.
That's why I'm being a little gentle there, especially in the first month or 2 months. And I use this on most of my trees. This is just the bob sticks from Amazon.
I have a package in my civil war drawer. Yeah. When you need a kebab.
No, final step. See the water? There's a product called Super Thrive. Super Thrive is like
rooting.
It's not rooting or it's not fertilizer. It's just like we taking vitamins.
Okay.
It'll just help your immune system. In the tree's case, it's a nice boost.
You know,
now we should have done this before. Yeah. Putting the moss. So let's see what happens.
I better do such a good tampering
I'm
job.
Put mine now because it's going to overflow. So we're going to leave it like 5 minutes or so.
Oh, yeah.
In the meanwhile, I can just dry the tools.
And then we'll just pull it out.
Yeah.
And we're set. Super cool. It looks, I mean, it seems so simple.
It's just the details.
And you gave me like 3 to 5 like good, easy to remember tips, but
yeah.
I feel like this is... There's so much more than this. Like, this is just getting going. I'm excited, though.
I'm also...
The tree itself is so cool.
I'm not an expert.
And from going from the bush to this,
yeah.
You know, and I like how it's... We're doing this because of this. We're doing this because of this.
Yeah.
You know?
So I'm going to tell you just one more thing. You see this gut? Anything that is more thick than your, what do you call this? The pinky nail. You should be careful, especially at this stage.
Close it up.
If we were in full spring where the tree is leafing out, I would not cut any single branch because the sap is flowing and it loses sap and it loses strength.
Yeah.
Because it's coming very soon, I am just going to put like
plug
a...
Your
yeah. In your case, it was all smalls.
Guys.
And I don't expect the tree to leaf out
in the
next
2 weeks. This is the special Japanese modeling clay.
Yeah. Can you read it?
Absolutely.
I don't know if it's Japanese or Chinese. It might be Chinese.
No, it's a knockoff Japanese.
Yeah. let me just clean it up. You want to dry your tools with this?
Sure.
You can do that.
Appreciate everything. This has been super cool. So I mean, I like growing stuff and I like wood. So this is definitely best of both worlds, you know?
This tree is going to develop.
Yeah. Well, this is the beginning.
Let's say that he grows tremendously and it doesn't make any sense. And he has like whips coming all out. By fall time, you can always cut them and try to root them with the root ball.
Oh, and then
you have the same one.
Grab more
on the next season. That's where you're gonna save.
Yes. So like this right now, right?
Yep. But right now, spring, it's not gonna. You would have to keep it without getting tremendous amount of sun, moist.
Yeah. Broad.
And the thing is that it's gonna push leaves. Then it doesn't have support from roots, so it's
gonna
if you do it in fall, the strength is in the branch, and in the fall, the whatever hormones they drop and they create roots.
Yeah,
because it's not leaking out.
So I also know when you do want to clone plants or different things like that, they say take from the bottom and that new growth.
Okay.
So yeah.
But I am not the most expert on that. I've tried and I had.
let's say Japanese maples, I have like 25%.
We'll reconvene in 7 years and we'll see what we come up with.
I would love to propagate this species.
Because it would be super cool, even if you had to have the almost like the egg starter where you cut them, you know, hormone them, you throw them in there.
I would definitely try to propagate it though. So right now it's like I'm gonna let them go without control and just fall if I have space and patience.
And then bring them back. So how long do we leave these? A year? 3 months? 2 years?
No. Well, it comes down to whatever you want to do, but...
So what would you do? So with this guy, do we just kind of let him bush out a little bit and see what he wants to?
Basically, you have to also keep in mind the when you can do things.
Yeah, so I think, you have the seasons.
Right now it's going to leaf out and grow in the first growth of the spring, which is like the first month or 2 months of the spring. They elongate, then they harden. You can cut back if you want. There's no need because it's on its
little guys, yeah.
But when it comes to fall, drops the leaves. Once the final leaves start dropping, that's when I do the most of the cutbacks. Because you don't have any problems with bleeding out, sap and all that. So fall time is basically time for me to wire and prune back to where I want it to be for the next spring. So I'm gonna make decisions on fall based on how I want it to move on in spring. If, for example, this in fall time is here and this is here, I would probably I would probably even leave this one if I wanted.
Yeah.
Because I want it to chunk up. Grow. The trunk. Yeah. But I don't want this one to chunk up, so I would cut back.
Cut him down.
And then you can also wire.
So in 6 to 9 months or so, we can relook at them.
Yeah.
And see which way they're going or which way we want them to go.
Mm-hmm. Basically fall time.
So fall time for us would be what? October, November?
Yeah. October-ish. September is still really hot. So
yeah, September is almost our hottest month.
So heavy tasks like pruning and bending, you don't want the weather to be hot. You don't want it to be really cold.
So right around, well, we got bumpkins, we're trimming trees.
Yeah. Right now we wait about a month or more until we see the tree healthy. And at that point, we can start fertilizing. Cool. I'll show you that.
So how long until I'm gonna have to water it? So I know we got the stick, but do you normally water 3-4 times a month?
No, this is not like the tomato or the cucumber or whatever.
Yeah,
those ones you can have the dirt dry basically, and they will still survive.
This one
this
always
has to
needs
be
to be
always
wet.
Moist, at the very minimum moist, especially the seedos, they cannot dry at all. So when you see the top layer dry, you want to inspect.
Check,
and you want to water.
So once the top layer dries out, 2-3 days it needs water.
Yeah.
And average. I know it always depends.
Yes, if it's summertime, you might even water 2 times a day.
Oh, so quite a bit.
Yeah.
So because the soil is so.
Yeah. If you want, and this is totally up to you.
I'll just bring them over. I'll go on vacation, drop them off.
Yeah, if you go on vacations, I'll
advise $2 a day.
Yeah. No, but if you want the first month, if you want me to keep it for at least 2 weeks, just to make sure that the tree is on where it's supposed to be, that, it's a good idea. If you feel comfortable watering it and controlling it also.
So
if you want to come and see me watering.
You're right. So as a tree like this, because this is the front one,
you know it.
How do I hit this again in 3-4 days?
Depends on the weather.
How often are you watering your other trees? Twice a week?
I'm going to say that I water some trees every week once. I have things that are sensitive and they dry the top layer and I have to water them every day.
I have trees every 2 days.
So how
you want to observe this changing color from the black or whatever is moist, especially this clay is going to change color.
Absolutely.
From wet to dry is going to be lighter. When you see that dry,
we're curious.
Yeah, go check it out.
And then how wet's too wet? Like, if I watered every 3 days and it drains, who cares?
You water plenty until it gets all soaked.
Yeah.
And just let it until the next watering. I basically do like...
Can we overwater? Because it's going to drain anyway.
You can,
so.
It's going to drain. You can overwater in ruin a tree if he has bad soil. This is top quality.
It's just, so it's hard to, because it dries so quick.
It's hard to make a mistake, and it's better to overwater in this case than
underwater. To underwater.
How do you know you overwatering is simple also? When it has leaves, if you're overwatering, the leaves will start turning yellow.
Okay.
Or very light.
Yeah.
If you underwater, they will dry and then you lose a bunch of branches. So it's better to overwater than underwater, in my opinion.
Yeah, and with the leaves, it's easier to tell.
Like right now, for example, tomorrow is going to be 65 or 60. It's pretty hot actually lately. You might want to check it in the end of the day if it needs to be water or not.
So then with your water, are you pulling this off of your...
It's from the company, but I have an RV filter.
So, has too much like water. I have a reverse osmosis, should I hit it with that water?
I had a discussion and I think people told me that it just takes too much minerals out of the water that the plants need.
So should I do half and half?
Do you have a RV house filter? Outside? They have a house outside that it's just company water?
Yeah.
Then this.
Yeah, do you have an RV filter?
No, just no. I can get one? I have a sprayer, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, you want to do it with a shower?
Yeah, just lightly.
Yeah, just
Cool, I think I'll put this on my front one. And we'll water in 10, 15 seconds, really just till it saturates it. You can almost see the water rise.
Yeah. Nope, you will drain immediately. You won't see it rise. If it's good soil and if it's done properly, you won't see it. But basically, let's say if I have my tree there, I'll just do like one pass, something like that. Make sure that it's draining well. And probably like 20 seconds, 30 seconds, I don't know.
So get happy and then give them a little extra.
Yeah.
Cool. So let's start with one.
I'll get you the babies after just because they're
That's super cool too.
No,
and that seems like a whole different.
It's just so small that anything like this will
disturb it.
Yeah. So my bonsai was actually, he's a lot more sensitive. Those hoses, they only have holes.
Oh yeah, around. So I get you, yeah.
And this one makes a lot more light rain.
Yeah.
And I can control it.
So that may be
you see, it's a lot flatter.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't even...
Is that a better...
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like $60 thing. This is recent. I didn't have it before. I had those sensitive ones. Only now.
I feel like the longer we work and whatever we're doing, the better our tools get. You know? So.